Hey everyone, Tankenstein here. War Thunder has just announced a new vehicle coming to this season of Battle Pass, Season 5 Battle Pass, that they have not named yet for whatever reason, but that's beside the point. And that is the Beaufighter Mk I. This is a premium rank 2 Battle Pass vehicle. It will be considered a strike aircraft, so it should get air spawn. And the special thing about it is that it will be getting two nose-mounted 40mm cannons, which could be good for a max of 70mm of armor pen. Now, this will likely be the Vickers S cannons found in the Hurricane Mk IV, but I did a little bit of research on the Beaufighter Mk I, and it's saying that they may be the 40mm Bofors cannons, which in that case could change their armor pen. So as I said before, this is a premium rank 2 vehicle, so it should be a pretty low BR. I'm guessing 2.3, 2.7, maybe 3.0, who knows? And it will have about 58 shells total, or 28 for each cannon. So one interesting thing that I noticed when I look at this plane is that in the pictures on the dev blog, we are not seeing a turret anywhere on this vehicle, which should be fairly interesting. Not that the turrets mattered all too much. It was just a single LMG basically on the top of the vehicle. But of course, they did matter a little bit. They'd be okay for getting assists, you know, in the process of dying. So this vehicle will not have that. One thing that I find a little concerning as a consumer of Battle Pass, I've purchased Battle Pass for all 4 seasons previously, one because I play a lot, but two because I am War Thunder content creator, so I more or less kind of get Golden Eagles anyway, so I can just get it, wouldn't be too much skin off my back. Now that being said, this is a little concerning because it is two. We have two rank 2 vehicles coming to Battle Pass for this newest update, and the other one that's been announced, the ship, will be a rank 3, and it's a coastal ship. So the only vehicle really of any note here will be the, in my opinion at least, the PT-76-57, which features an automatic cannon, which is really, really cool. But again, pretty much every single vehicle in this battle pass thus far has been a little bit low, at least when it comes to rank. And between this and the LVT-440, I'm not expecting really either of those to get beyond 3.0 PR. So it's, in my opinion, again, a little bit concerning. When it came to Battle Pass Season 1, we had crazy ridiculous BRs. I mean, the average BR in that was like 5 point something or the other. I had it written down somewhere, but it was above 5.0. I'm thinking that we might get below 4.5 BR on average for the rewards for this. We might even have a below 4.0, well, probably not a below 4.0 BR average reward level for these ones, but it might be pretty close. So it's a little bit concerning what we're getting. I mean, heck, who knows if the PT-76-57 turns out to be amazing, it could make up for the rest of it. But again, what's the point of getting battle pass if every single vehicle is such a low BR that it won't even affect you, it won't even benefit you later on? I mean, either way, just let me know in the comments below what you guys think about this plane. I think it's really cool, but I just wish that there were at least a few other vehicles coming in this battle pass that were a little bit more special, you know? I feel like this would be a great close air support vehicle, but again, it will be a low ranking vehicle, so it won't be able to help you too far up in the tech tree, and it won't be able to help you grind for too long. But that being said, let me know again what you guys think in the comments below. Is this really worth 2,000 or 2500 GE from the battle pass vehicles that we've seen so far? Will there be a fifth one? Who knows? Because so far we've had this vehicle, the LVT-440, the PT-76-57, and that PT boat, which looks like it'll be a ton of fun. But again, it's a PT boat that will likely be facing destroyers, and so it will likely get destroyed, plus it's naval. So that being said, yes, a lot of people do play naval. I like naval occasionally, but not a ton of people play it. Either way, with that all out of the way, just let me know in the comments below. I'm not going to drag this video out for really any longer. I do have a video coming out tomorrow that will actually give one of my suggestions for improving War Thunder will be centered at least partially around Battle Pass. So subscribe if you want to check that out. That way you'll get a notification when it hits the interwebs. By the way, this is Tankenstein here. Thanks so much for watching my video. Please like, comment, subscribe as I just mentioned, and I will see you all on the other side. Thanks so much and take care, everyone.